How many of you over here have ever had a dream for yourself? How many of you over here ever decided to give up on something you really wanted? How many of you over here ever gave up on something because you felt you weren't good enough to achieve your dream? Right. Before we even move ahead, I want to show you what the definition, dictionary definition of a dream really means. Okay. The dictionary definition of what a dream really means is something that you really want, something that you really, really want, but is not likely to happen. I really want you to focus on the part where it says, not likely to happen. If I look back at my life, I want to be really honest. I had numerous incidences where I really wanted something from the bottom of my heart, but I felt like it's not likely to happen. There are reasons why it happens, right? I remember this one incident. I was in my second or third standard, and I went to my school principal once. And she asked me, Aarzoo, what do you want to become when you grow up? What is your dream? And I told her that I want to become a doctor. There was this little girl, you know, with spark in her eyes. I told her, ma'am, I want to become a doctor when I grow up. And she tells me that if you successfully become a patient, it'll be good enough for you. Now that broke something inside me. You know, it breaks something inside a little person who has some dreams in life. I had numerous incidences like this. I grew up being underconfident, being insecure. I always doubted myself, lot of questions. I never really understood how to value myself enough. My insecurities a lot of times got the best out of me. One of the incidents was when I was 15. Actually, I grew up in a Gujarati joint family. And along with all the other people in my family, I never really had a great relationship with my grandmother. I used to have a lot of arguments. I was this spoiled little brat. I never could have the kind of relationship I really wanted to have. I remember when I was around 15, she had fallen really sick. She'd been sick for around 6 months. That one day, you know, for those 6 months, I really tried hard to mend my relationship with her. I wanted to make some good memories because she was old, she was sick. We knew the message. I tried really hard. This one day, something happened and I lost it again. We had an argument. I left home, I went out. I come back and she's unconscious. She stayed unconscious for around 3 days. All those 3 days, I was praying. I think I was practically begging to God to do something. You know, I wanted to mend things. I wanted to make it right. The reality is, the third day, she passed away. I dived into guilt. I dived into guilt to a level that you find hard to imagine. Self-hate, everything possible on this planet, I dived into all of it. You know, I wrote letters and I threw it under the oceans. I went to frames and I tried to talk to her. I wrote letters and I sent it to temples to find some closure for myself in a little way. The reality is, life doesn't always give you second chances. That's the truth. I didn't get a second chance. After, I don't know how many time of spending in guilt and hate, one day I decided that I wanted to do something better. I can't change the past. What I have for me is the future. I can do something. I had failed as a granddaughter, that was the reality. I did not want to fail as a friend, as a sister, as a daughter, as a mother. More than anything else, that day I decided I don't want to fail as a human being. I want to become a better person. So I went on this journey to learn how to become a better person. I went on to study psychology. I did a lot of research. I started reading. I started understanding. One of the first things that I discovered in this journey was I wasn't alone. I looked around and majority of us spent most of our time in insecurities, in doubt, in fear, questioning our worth, asking ourselves whether we are good enough for something or not. At the same time, on the other hand, I found out that there were people that were better. There were people who were doing much better. Look at someone like Oprah Winfrey for that matter, right? She has been through molestation. She's been through challenges that me and you sitting over here today find it so hard to contemplate, yet she's an inspiration to millions of people across the globe. Look at someone like Shah Rukh Khan, you know, a name that is so popular for all of us. Right now talking about him brings a smile to my face. Someone who has the classic rags to riches story, coming from a no background to today becoming the Badshah of this country. Look at someone like Rutika Sriram. When I first met her, what I thought was she's national champion in diving, 10 years, amazing. When I first met her, she told me where she comes from, a small village in Maharashtra that doesn't even have a swimming pool. Yet representing India in Commonwealth Games, Asian Games and where not. I wanted to understand what was the difference. How people over here who were questioning their worth, their self-value, in their doubts and insecurities could come here where people are inspiring millions, living the life they want. What was that one difference between these two people? That I could understand, that we could understand and come here when we want. So I went on this journey. I worked with some of the most successful people that you can think of in our country to some of the simplest people this nation had ever seen, looking for answers to find out what was that secret. What I was hoping to find out was a secret that no one had heard, you know, something that we had never heard of, we had never thought of, a sort of mystery, something truly magical. The fact is, I did find out something truly magical. Yet, it was a truth that was so old, so frequently expressed, yet so easily forgotten. Something that we all know. All these people were aligned to something meaningful, something really, really important to them. All these people, every single one of them, had a dream for themselves. At this moment, I want to take you back to the definition. Something that you really want, but is not likely to happen. The hint is, it's upon us to make it happen. When I discovered this truth, I decided that I want to set dreams. I want to spread this message across to every single person that I can. I want to tell everyone, go ahead and dream. To do that, when this year started, I wrote down three dreams for myself. Three dreams that I really wanted to achieve. The first one was to start my own seminars. To go ahead, empower people to follow their own dreams, sort of hold their hand across the journey. The second dream that I had for myself was write a book, to spread this message to more and more people. The third dream that I had for myself was to spread this message globally. My first dream I achieved this year in August when I started my own seminars. I've been doing it every weekend after that, empowering people to follow their dreams. The second dream that I had was to write my book, which I published just yesterday. It's pre-launched yesterday. My third dream, to spread this message globally, is coming true at this moment when I'm standing in front of you and giving this. The fact here is, it sounds great, right? I wrote dreams, I manifested them, and it came true. Here is where I want you to pause. It's not likely to happen. I don't think they get manifested. What I want to share here with you is something I discovered across my journey, something that thousands of people have used and something that me and you today here can use to make our dreams come true. A simple four-step system that we all can use to make our dreams come true, which is, I like to call, Dare to Dream. D stands for Discover Your Dream. When I talk about discovering your dream, me and you every day have millions of thoughts, hopes, aspirations, desires, doubts, everything in one go. The fact is, we are living to survive. Every day we get up, go to our job, do our work, come back home, sleep, have a good weekend, and repeat the cycle for the rest of our life till we retire one day. What I'm asking you to do here is find something that is meaningful to you, something that you really feel for in your heart, something that you truly, truly want. I don't know what that means to you, right? It's very subjective. You would want to become the next prime minister of this nation. Maybe you just want to take care of your family. Maybe it's a combination of both the things. For me, it was impacting people, making a difference in this world. What is that one thing for you? Pause, ask yourself. I know you have an answer. I know there is something you truly feel for. The second thing is taking action. See, dreams are great. We've all written dreams, sometimes had them in our mind that we did not even go ahead and follow. What makes the difference is when you define your actions. What is it that you will do for your dream? For me, it was to make a difference, but I decided to, you know, jot it down into steps that I could take. For example, my channel, my workshops, writing a book, standing here is a defined action towards my dream. Define the actions. It'll only work that way. The third thing over here is reinvent your belief. Believe in yourself. Believe in your dreams. How many times have we heard this, either while swiping through Instagram or some great person one day came and told, came and told us that, you know what, you need to believe in yourself. Let me be honest, even after the industry and the work that I come from, no one can stand here in front of you one day and tell you that believe in yourself and you'll start doing it. I only wish it happened that way. It doesn't work like that. If you spent most of your life questioning yourself like I had done, it can't happen in one day. The way it can happen is when you take small little actions towards your dream, your self-belief increases. Then you take another action and it increases. Then you take another action and it increases till it becomes natural to you. The truth is, none of us are ever born with self-belief. You teach that to yourself one day at a time through small little actions. For me, when I started my work, I made my first video, I started my channel, I never thought honestly in my heart that I would do anything that is accountable, anything that makes me amount for something. But when that first girl sent me a message that, hey Didi, thank you so much for doing what you're doing, you made me feel like I'm a better person today, that increased my self-belief. Then the next person, then the next person, then I saw the proof that I could make a difference. That's when my self-belief increased. I think that's the only way it works. One day at a time, you teach yourself. The last thing is, earn your dreams. You see, we come from a generation where we've got it all easy. We've got it all quick. You want to talk to someone, send them a message on WhatsApp, anywhere that you want, and you get a reply and you can talk to the person. You want something, order online, and it arrives the next day. You want to watch something, you don't wait week to week. You go online and binge watch everything that you want. Things like fulfillment, happiness, accomplishments, dreams, achievements. I only wish they came so easy. Okay, let me forget that. I don't hope they came so easy, because if they did, they wouldn't be worth it. The fact is, if something is worth having, you have to earn it. I really like this rule by Malcolm Gladwell, where he says that behind any great achievement, there is 10,000 hours of work. If your dream is worth having, you're going to have to earn it. One day at a time. I know how great this sounds at this point, right? You have something, you want to do it, there are four simple steps. Discover your dream, take actions, reinvent your beliefs, go ahead and earn your dream and you have it. So I wrote three dreams for myself. I had the four steps. It sounds great. The fact is, when this year started, the first 6 months of this year, I didn't accomplish even one of those things. And it was very hard. I felt like giving up every single day. Because when it doesn't work out, it's not easy. Especially for someone like me, I'm inherently competitive as a person. I can't take failures easily. For me, it takes tubs of ice creams and loads of tears to come out of something that didn't work out for me, something that I had put my heart and soul into. But it gets difficult. It will. Yet you will stick to it because it is important to you. Each day. Because you want it to happen. You see, we look around at people sometimes and we see how they've got it easy, how it's worked out for them. You know, we've all learned about the law of manifestation where you can manifest your dreams. The fact is, it doesn't work like that. Life has a dream for you to have a dream. Yet, life is counting on you to make it happen. The universe is conspiring things for you, but the universe is counting on you to take some action towards it. That's what I taught myself each day to work towards my dream. The thing is, you will look around at people and you will feel they've got it better, they've got it easier, and you have not. Here's a fun fact that I want to share with you. Someone will always have it better. Here's another fun fact that I want to share with you. There is one thing that you can have better than all of them combined, is you have yourself to make better each day at a time, to believe in yourself and to believe in your dreams. And then they do come true. Before I end this, before I summarize this entire thing for you, I want to tell you one last thing. I looked at myself. For the first 19 years of my life, I felt like a loser. Insecure, underconfident, felt like I'll never amount for anything big in life, anything that's even important in life. Yet there is one thing that I did, and there is one thing that I've seen thousands of people do over the last 1 year, and that is one thing I want to invite each one of you to do. Just remember this one thing. Dare to dream. Thank you so much.